they connected with Esau and they in these companies and all this stuff. A lot of them, guess what they do? They form hate groups because they miserable as hell at home. For real, by themselves. And they complain, I can't find no decent black man. No nigga want to pull up with your goddamn attitude. The only man you want to respect is Esau. No, nobody want to put up with that. Are you crazy?
So you believe that there's a secret relationship between the so-called black woman and Esau?
Oh, yes. Since the dawn of time, you look at the Eve and how Satan, the serpent, right? You take it back to that, right? Here it is. You got the man in his rightful position, the woman in her rightful position. Look, peace and harmony. They want nothing that she ain't need. But what did he offer her? Because Satan going to offer you the things that you desire. Adam desired a wife. Most High gave it to him.
Right.
Everything he ever desired, that's complete. She, what did he offer her? If you eat that fruit, you will be like God.
Yeah.
Adam was already like God, being the image and the likeness of him.
He
had the authority over all things.
Yeah.
The scriptures tell us that
the scriptures tell us that the woman was made for the man.
There you go.
It says she was made for the man. The scriptures clearly say that.
This is what they're rebelling against.
Yeah, they're rebelling.
This is why they'll always be unhappy, because it is in their nature.
Yeah.
Nature will never change. No matter what you do, no matter what you say, your nature, you can try to tweak it, but when you pretend to live outside of your nature, when you live outside of your nature, you are miserable. You never find peace.
So what do you think, the black woman calls the cops on her black husband? Do you think that's because she doesn't love him? Well, I mean, I'm not talking about a man that's been physically abusing her, beating her, and all of that.
You're talking about a righteous brother who's doing right by her.
A righteous brother is trying to do right. He may not have a job at the time. And she get upset because he start to talk back to her, and she called the cops and get him thrown out, like the brother was saying.
See, a lot of these women, see, they got Esau in their minds, Esau's in their heart. Come on, man. The scriptures tell you you can't serve two masters. That applied in this situation too. They got Esau as the top notch in their mind and in their heart. They got that white Christ in their heart. When they see you, they see niggas.
Right, they see monkey.
They see thug. They see everything that's wrong with the world when they look at you. When they look at him, they see everything that's right with the world.
So, I mean, you've been a man of a most high. Do you think there's any hope for that kind of relationship where the black woman calls the cops on her black husband that hasn't done her no harm other than talk back to her? And she said, this is my house. You ain't got no job. Get out. I'm going to call the cops. And when you don't leave, she called the cops.
That brother should leave that woman immediately. Because a lot of times when these women do these things, just like it's way more other examples, these women do not think at all. They don't think about the consequences of their action. They are thinking about their emotional outburst at that time. They not even going to think about the full effects and the whole picture. They not even thinking about that at all. They thinking about this moment right here that we argue about, I need to best you in. Even if the argument ain't about nothing. We could be arguing about, I like apples, you like oranges. And we arguing it. In her mind, I got to do whatever it takes to win the apple-orange argument.
Even if
it's drastic and insane. This is why you have brothers who, I know of a brother in Portsmouth who got in an argument with his baby mama, and he tries to call for a ride, and she's fighting on him, literally hitting him in his face, and he's trying to avoid her and tell her, stop hitting me. She hits him in the nose. His reaction, he swings back with the phone still in his hand, and he hits her in the face. She calls the police, and the police show up, and guess what she tells them that he's always been abusive, because they asked him, because, this is the secret relationship. This is the unspoken relationship. Esau come in, and his mind is, I know she called me to sell him out. And her mind is, oh, he gonna offer me the deal? Cool. I'm mad not because he's been a horrible father. I'm mad not because he's treated me bad all the time. I'm mad because I have to win this argument. This particular one argument in this moment,
yeah.
I have to win it. And it don't matter the cost. So what she said was...
So you're saying she will ruin this man's life for a petty argument.
She has to win the argument. See,
damn.
The difference between... And a lot damn. Of these... A lot of... Yes, yes.
But it's that sick. Much, y'all,
it's that sick. It's that sick. Come on. It's that sick. And a lot of these dudes have taken on this same female spirit where they argue the same way. Brothers, when they argue, they are actually trying to establish a logic and reason, a point that's being made. And when the point is clarified and being made, for the most part, respectable men will end the conversation or say, well, I have to research that information. That's interesting, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But a woman don't care how many times you made your point. You could have made your point 100 million times. When you're done with the argument, she'll tell you she fully understood everything that you were saying, yet she continued. Why does she continue? Because for her, it's all about getting you more emotional. Because women can think more clearly in their emotions than men can. Men, we become very basic. You see what I'm saying? You're a problem, I need to remove you. No. When women go into fight, they be thinking about they got their earrings and all this, that, and the third. And we ain't that, look, we forgot we even had anything on. It's time to rumble. You see what I'm saying? So they're thinking while they're doing all this crazy stuff. And the one thing that they have to do is they have to get you emotional. Because they get you emotional, they win. That's the one thing that she have over you. You're a major point. Everything you said makes sense. But you're not emotional enough.
Okay.
That's all I need to come out of you. All I need, whether you break down and cry, whether you scream and holler, whatever emotion come out of you, that's my victory. And a lot of these guys, they following, they've been raised by their mama. And they took on that same spirit. And that's how they argue nowadays. They don't argue to establish a point to make sense out of what the dispute is. They don't argue to make sense out of what the difference is. You said this and he said this. Well, I brought up the text message and here go the proof right here. And if that's the proof right there, that should be the end of the argument. A lot of these guys will keep arguing with you.
Right.
That's the senseless babbling. So when Esau showed up and he suggests to her, well, have he been abusive this whole time? And you know what she says? Yes, he have. And they considered him hitting her when he reacted with a cell phone assault with a deadly weapon. Put this man in prison for many years. And then you know what they did? They said, well, if he been abusing this whole time, those kids is not safe with you. And removed their kids. Removed their kids. He locked up. She ain't got her children. Children in foster care.
Right.
See, these women think Esau got their best interest because Esau will use you and throw you away as soon as he can. When you no longer useful, time to throw you away. That's what these women don't understand. That he's just using you for a particular purpose, for a particular point. And you got to understand that you can't go nowhere without your black and Hispanic man. You're not going nowhere. You went into slavery the same way. If you desire your freedom, if you desire peace of mind, if you desire a better living condition, both of y'all need to work together and use your elements because both of y'all have two different natures. You are a support. He is a leader. Simple, plain. Nobody even argues about this crap
right.
in other countries.
Right,
this
right,
is
right.
only because this white man has developed this foolish scheme and they have flipped everything upside down and fed it to our people. And this all our people know. And we get rewards like little pets, little animals. We get doggy biscuits for doing exactly as we are told.
Yeah, there's a lot of Eves that's real submissive before they come to America. But once they, you know, get in contact with that American black woman, they just totally lose Finish. Order, man.
Finish. And it's the same deal. It's the same deal that Satan offered Eve. If you listen to me, I'll give you authority that's equal to or greater than your husband.
Yep.
And they take that deal. They sell him out. They sell the kids out. And then they got the nerve to talk about love. You don't love nothing but that material that you sold him out for. That's all you love. That's your God. And Esau knows that. Esau knows that. If you ain't gonna stand for anything, you'll fall for anything. Esau knows that, man. That's how Esau think. That's why the first thing when he goes into a land, he ain't thinking about no goddamn friendship. Where the gold at? That's what he came over here for. Where the diamonds at? Where the resources at? This is where it goes through Esau's mind constantly. And now he has taught our people to think and function the same way. That's why you got brothers who messed up in the head and they got this money is my God mentality. And they end each other's lives over the pettiest things. You stepped on my shoes. You got to die. But then you look at stuff on the news, like the woman that got her house kicked in by SWAT and killed. And it don't even budge. Look, warrior spirit gone. Warrior spirit gone. Because it's a father relationship that's going on. That's why the scriptures say you of your father the devil and his desires you shall fulfill. Because they, when they do that, when they follow after this man and his teachings and his ways, he has become a father to you in nature. He has become a father to you in spirit. And everything that he desires you will do. I just seen a video the other day where they said there's been reports of people dropping crates.
So once again, let me make sure I can see it. So once again, yeah, it's Kahan Tazadaq, the Eliezer.
Shalom.
And of course,
Mr. Gons.
Okay. I mean, so basically, he's here and he's probably playing the devil's advocate. But we basically here talk about a lot of you Akim out there, you actually are allowing your woman to manipulate you. Kahan. Many of you are so strung out on the JJ that you're just weak. You're not acting like a damn man. You're like a little damn sissy. Mm-hmm. So you know a lot of you're teaching against polygamy because you under your damn woman, and you're not strong enough to tell her no, honey. This is in the scriptures. So you're allowing your woman to manipulate you, and you're not walking with the Most High if you are allowing your woman to rule over you. So all of you Israelites that's claiming to be like men of the Lord, and you're allowing your woman to rule over you, you're not a man of the Most High. The Most High is not accepting men with that spirit.
You can't use a man like that.
The Most High cannot use a man like that. It clearly tells us in the book of Genesis that the woman was created for the man. Mm-hmm. She was created to be a helpmeet for the man, mm-hmm. not to be a smart mouth. Not to rule over the man, but for the man. And if you sisters out there that don't like this, then shalom, have a nice day. You're not going to make it anyways. Because your smart mouth and your disrespectful, rebellious spirit is going to get you caught up. And you're going to get caught up without your nature. Because the scripture says in 1 Samuel 15, 23, rebellion is like the sin of witchcraft. Mm-hmm. So when you rebel against this, if your husband is coming at you through the spirit of righteousness and truth, you're not rebelling against him.
God.
You're rebelling against the Most High.
God.
You're rebelling against the Most High.
The scripture tells you that.
The scriptures tell us that. But the first scripture I want to start with is, you know, a lot of brothers out there, you know, they're rib. And when I say rib, I mean your woman, because Eve came from Adam's rib. So that's your rib, and she's with you. God. Your rib is online on Facebook talking to all of these other men, and you letting her get away with it. You know, she won't in Esau society, and you know, she may go on a vacation or something, he may go on a vacation, and they come back from vacation and she's hugging another damn man, which is against the scriptures. Or she's going out, oh, I just went out and had a drink with so-and-so. She's not supposed to be out there with another man. And since the scriptures say to prove all things, I'm going to prove that. The book of Sirach, the 9th chapter, 9th verse. And it reads,
set not at all with another man's wife, nor sit down with her in thy arms. So that kills you being with another man's wife alone at all. And you're not supposed to be hugging her. Mm. Because it says, set not with her in thy arms. And spend not thy money with her at the wine. So you're not supposed to be buying her drinks. You're not supposed to be taking her out to Starbucks and buying her drinks. Or taking out and getting her some Alizé. Or getting her some Hennessy. Mm-hmm. And so on and so forth. So you're not supposed to be sitting down with this man's wife and spending your money on her for wine. Why? Lest thine heart incline unto her, meaning you may start to like her, or that spirit of lust may jump on you, and so through thy desire, thou fall into destruction. Why? Because you're going to commit adultery. She might provoke you to commit adultery. So brothers, all of you out there that's dealing with other men's women, stop it. Stop it now, because you're going against the laws of the scriptures. What you got, huh?
The Most High said that a man that take another man's wife, he deserved death. You see what I'm saying? That's a serious matter. Now, like the brother read from the scriptures, it tell you don't be just sitting, chilling with another man's wife. That's out of order. You're not supposed to be having your arm all around her and hugging up on her and all that. That's another man's wife.
Right.
That's out of order. And like the brother said, when you do that, it the spirit of lust might get on her or you. You see what I'm saying? Because you got to understand that the devil seek whom he may devour. Like, you ain't even come. Your mind wasn't even on that before you met the sister. But then the spirit of lust, because the devil, Satan, is waiting for any opportunity. You giving him an opening. When you set yourself up like that, you giving him an opening. Right. The scriptures talk about how you're not supposed to leave no place for Satan. I'm going to go to that in Ephesians. In Ephesians, it tell you not to leave place for Satan, because that's what you're doing. When you get in those situations where you just with another man's wife, y'all just hanging out and you buying her drinks or whatever. You're not supposed to be doing that. So this is Ephesians. Let me see. Ephesians 4. I'm going to start at Ephesians 4. And I'm going to read at verse 20. It said, but ye have not so learned Christ, if so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth in Yahawashah, that ye put off concerning the formal conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to deceitful lust.
Right.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind, that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. It says in verse 26, be ye angry and sin not, let not the sun go down upon your wrath. In verse 27, here it is. Neither give place to the devil. There we go right there.
Right. So, I mean, basically, when you sit with another man's rib, especially if she's an attractive sister or something, you might yield to temptation. You know, especially, and I'm going to hit you with something. A lot of these men out here are... What they do is they find a woman when she's very vulnerable. Her and her husband might have actually been engaged into an argument. Then he's like, oh, sis, you don't have to take that. You shouldn't be going through that. You need someone that's going to treat you right. But that's the spirit of Satan, man. You don't have anything to do with that man's marriage. That's between her and the Most High. Unless he gets violent, then you take it to the priest.
Uh-huh.
Or you take it to the congregation or the elders. But you don't have nothing to do with that. But a lot of you men are wicked. And you sisters are wicked for going to him. And I'm hit you with something, man. You know, all of you brothers out there, if you're dealing with the kind of woman, you know, where... I'm going to tell you something, man. If you're living with a woman and your name is not on the lease, you need to get your name on the lease or you find your own place. You got to be a man. Because I'm going to hit you with something. When she gets angry, if she gets tired of you, If you lose your job or something, and she will get tired of you, unless she's a righteous, truly righteous, God-fearing woman, she's going to get tired of you. She's going to start to look down on you. And the scriptures back that up, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when a woman has to, you know,
maintain her husband.
Mm-hmm. So when she get tired of you, she's going to tell you to get out. And if you don't get out, she's going to call the cops on you. Now, you're gonna remember that I said that through the Spirit. And some of you can receive this because it's already happened to some of you. Mm-hmm. Your woman has already thrown you out, but you was weak because you went back to her. If a so-called black woman ever calls a cop on you, man, you're supposed to never go back to that woman unless you was beating her, because she don't give a damn about you. And that's a dangerous woman to be with. And you need to get that through your head. Mm-hmm. And I'm not speaking from emotions. I'm speaking from the Spirit. If your wife ever called the cops on you, you need to leave her alone, because it's not going to turn out good for you, man. It's not going to turn out good for you. Yeah, I got one scripture about it. Sirach 25:13. It says, and I'm going to show you how bad a wicked woman is. A man can be wicked. A child could be wicked. But there's no wickedness like the wickedness of a woman. Which is proved with that damn Jezebel spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But the scripture said to prove all things. So Sirach 25:13. It says, give me any plague. Give me any plague. HIV, West Nile virus. What's that? Zika virus.
Uh-huh.
You know? Hepatitis. Yep. Uh-huh. Give me any plague but the plague of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And any wickedness but the wickedness of a woman. Now that's powerful, man.
Yeah, that's powerful.
What you got, Al?
I got in Sirach 23:17. It said, All bread is sweet to a whoremonger, and he will not leave off till he die. So that brother with that whoremonger spirit, he gonna be looking at your wife.
Right.
He gonna be lurking. He gonna be praying. He ain't gonna never be satisfied. He gonna never have enough women.
Right.
Till he die. It said, a man that breaketh wedlock, saying thus in his heart, who seeth me, I am compassed about with darkness, and the walls cover me, nobody seeth me, that need I to fear. What need I to fear? The Most High will not remember my sins. Such a man only fear the eyes of men, and knoweth not that the eye of the Lord is 10,000 times brighter than the sun, beholding all the ways of men and considering the most secret parts. So the Most High is saying, you worried about somebody catching you, and you're not worried about the Most High judgment falling upon you.
Right.
Don't set yourself up for those situations. Now, the scriptures say in Exodus 20 and verse 17, this is one of the most untalked about commandment, but it's extremely important. It said, thou shalt not cover thy neighbor's house. That's for you men and women who are jealous. You trying to keep up with the Joneses, as they say. You jealous of, oh, look how sparkling and beautiful this house is. My neighbor or whatever. Thou shalt not cover thy neighbor's wife. That's that same scenario that we were just talking about.
That's right.
A brother sitting and lurking and waiting for problems to arise in your relationship with your wife. That's you, your wife, and the Most High's business. That has nothing to do with that other man, that outside force. But he's sitting back, he lurking, and he got covetousness in his heart. It said, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thy neighbor. That fall under anything that belongs to your neighbor. You're not supposed to be lusting after those things. So go ahead.
Right. So you know, I just wanted to bring out that scripture. So, Sirach, 25:22. It says, a woman, if she maintains her husband, is full of anger, impudence, and much reproach.
Mm.
A wicked woman abateth the courage and maketh heavy countenance. Meaning it make the man stressful. He's stressed out all the time.
Huh.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you got some brothers, that feel like they want to harm themselves because her mouth is driving him crazy and he don't know what to do with it. He don't want to put his hands on her, so he think about hurting himself.
God.
Some women will drive men to that if the man is not strong enough.
Mm-hmm.
And a wounded heart. A woman that will not comfort her husband in distress maketh weak hands and feeble knees. So if your husband is going through a hard time, you know, he might have lost his job or something, and you stressing a man out, oh, get a job. You need to get a job. You need to get out here and do something. You can't stay here all day in the house and do nothing. Well, I mean, the world has actually basically changed the way that people apply for jobs. The man could be right in the house and applying for positions online. Because people really don't really accept hard applications anymore. They're basically submitted online. Mm-hmm. So what is she complaining about? And mm-hmm. then you, some of you women out there, you pretend you want to help your husband and you pretend you love him, but you don't even let the man use a damn car to try to get to work and get the job interviews and try to do the things that is actually necessary. It's a necessity for him to actually do better. Why? Because you're wicked. But you're trying to come off like you're full of righteousness.
What you got? The scripture says in Proverbs 21 and 19, it says, it is better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and an angry woman.
So you better off just living in the goddamn wrong wilderness.
Yeah, you better living in the wilderness somewhere.
In other words, leave her alone.
You are safe in the wilderness than you are with that wicked woman.
In other words, get the hell away from that woman, man. Because she will break you, man.
Con.
Just like Jezebel, she will break you with that Jezebel spirit, man.
Con. That spirit ain't no joke.
It's Sirach 26, verse 7. It says, an evil wife is a yoke shaken to and fro. Now, you know, a yoke is what they put on the slave's neck. But not even a yoke is supposed to shake to and fro. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to be stationary. Yeah. But when something's shaking to and fro, it's even more irritable. Uh-huh. It makes you more irritable.
Con.
He that hath hold of her is though he held a scorpion.
Con.
Wow. So she's going to sting you. Uh-huh. She's going to sting you. She's going to betray your ass. Mm-hmm. I'm going to hit you, son. If you're not careful, a woman like that will end up sleeping with one of your friends. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tell you something, man. Don't be bringing your woman to camp and all of that unless there's sisters there, unless there's a gathering with sisters. Don't be bringing your woman around a lot of different men because there's a lot of wicked Israelites out that pretend that they're righteous.
Uh-huh.
And they're looking at your woman, man. And you watch the people when you're going to camping or if you're taking your woman out there. You pay attention to the ones that keep looking at your rib. That's a wicked Negro, man.
Uh-huh. That's the one with that covetousness in his heart. And he waiting for his opportunity. I got me a scripture, Proverbs 27 and 15. It says, a continual dropping in a very rainy day and a contentious woman are alike. So you being in your man, you see what I'm saying? You being in your man, just want to argue about every single thing. It's like somebody just dropping drops on your forehead.
Right. It's just irritable.
Just driving irritable. You mad. Just driving you crazy. It says, whosoever hideth her, and you trying to hide it from the brothers.
Right.
She ain't that bad.
Yeah,
it ain't that bad. But she frustrating you to the point where it's driving you crazy like the continual dropping of the water in a rainy day. It said, whosoever hideth her, hideth the wind. It's like you trying to grab hold of the wind. You can't hold the wind. So, the point is, y'all brothers got to examine what type of woman you really got. Right. Because these women can make you or break you.
That's right.
And listen, you don't need her. This is the problem. You need the Most High.
That's right.
We don't see it that way. We got the thing backwards. We say her, then the Most High. No, it's the Most High.
That's right.
And then her. Right. We got it flipped all around. You see what I'm saying? This is why our houses is not in order. This is why we suffering so much. Now, when you go to Proverbs 31, this was a wise woman. Solomon's mother taught him how to deal with women. And you know what she said? I'm going to start at verse 1 so you can see is his mother. This is chapter 31 of Proverbs in verse 1. The words of King Lemuel, the prophecy that his mother taught him. So this was a righteous woman that taught him these prophecies in this parable. It said, "What, my son? And what, the son of my womb? And what, my son of my vow, the son of my vows? Give not thy strength unto women, nor thy ways to that which destroy kings."
Right.
So listen to what she's telling him. She warned him, don't fall for that. Don't fall for that. Don't give your strength to your woman, because she's going to take that strength and destroy you with it.
Right, right, right. So you gotta have your homes in order. And I'm going to tell you something, man. You know, a lot of you brothers, your woman has told you, stop hanging around those Israelite brothers. I don't want you around them. And you're weak as hell, so you do it. You listen to your woman, and she's going to betray you. She's going to end up committing adultery on you. Anytime a woman is trying to stop you from being around righteous men, that's not the woman to deal with. I mean, if you was with some Negro going out to this club, smoking blunts, and so on and so forth, getting high, she would be cool with that. And then one of them Negroes would end up sticking his rod up in her and defiling her. But you trying to be around righteous brother, trying to teach you the word of the Most High, she's telling you don't be around them, because her spirit is rebuking it. Her spirit is going against it, and your house is not in order. But the scripture said, if you are a man of the Most High, you must set your house in order. If you are a man of the Most High, you're supposed to be ruling that house. The woman is not supposed to be ruling that house. Let me get that. 2 Edges, the 14th chapter, verse 13. "Now therefore, set thine house in order, and reprove thy people." So we're supposed to cut you. This is not personal. We're supposed to reprove you. We're giving you reproof right now. We're reproving the people, because many of you brothers do not have your house in order. Now, I have a wife that's very attractive, but my wife know damn well if she does it, if she trying to get in the way of me and this truth, shalom, she can have a nice day. Because the Most High blessed me with another wife more nearer in righteousness, and she don't want to be in this truth. I don't force her to stay with me. I'm not going to cry, you know, or something like that, because if anyone try to get in the way of me in this work, shalom, have a nice day.
I got a script. Now, what these brothers don't understand is the Most High have your best interests.
That's right.
Not this woman. The Most High have your best interests. I'm going to read the scripture. I'm going to show you something. In Matthew's 3 and 11, verse 11 and verse 12. It said, "I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance, but he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire." Right? It said, whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge the floor and gather his wheat unto the gather, and will burn up the calf with unquenchable fire. Now, what this is talking about is the fire is these trials that you're going to have to go to. That's why the scripture says in Sirach, watch this. I'm going to show you.
And we're not picking on sisters. It's just that a lot of sisters out there are off. And those of you that come into this truth, you want to be out there teaching men, you're not supposed to be teaching men. You're supposed to be teaching other women and children if you're learned. You're not supposed to be teaching them the men. The woman is to remain silent. Shh. Be quiet.
If you go to Ecclesiasticus 2 and 5, it said, for gold is tried in the fire, and acceptable men in the furnace of adversity. So the fire is your trials to make you a better righteous woman or make you a better righteous man. Now, the scriptures talk about how in Proverbs 13 and 2, it said, "He that walketh with wise men shall be wise." So is she trying to keep you from those righteous men? That's not good.
That's right.
She trying to remove your wisdom. You see what I'm saying? See, a lot of these brothers, when they wake up, they're with these worldly women.
Right.
And it's hard for them to just let them go because they've been with them for so long. And what's happening is she was running him.
Right.
But then when he started standing on the word of truth, she perceived that this is a threat. Every time this brother go with these brothers, he gets stronger.
Right, that's right.
I can't manipulate him like I used to.
Because the word's
going up. He keep giving me word, and I can't fight the word.
Right.
So what I got to do is, I got to remove him from these people who's giving him the word and the spirit of the Most High so that he can win his bouts against me who is against that word. See, a lot of brothers don't realize that it's just like what the scriptures say. Ain't no wickedness greater than the wickedness of a woman. I didn't write that. That's in the Bible. Right. Now watch this. He said I had rather dwell with a lion and a dragon than to keep house with a wicked woman.
A lion, because, a
wicked part. Yeah. He would rather be in that joint fighting a lion and a dragon than be fighting with a wicked woman. This woman setting all kinds of traps for you. You don't even know it.
Right.
You don't even know it.
Right. And your woman knows you. She studies you. Women are more studious than men, and they pay more attention, and they play better semantics than men. So that woman would study you, find your weaknesses, and break you down. Unless you were strong enough. She would break you down.
And the only thing you got is believing, following the Most High. That's your only advantage. If you go in your carnal mind, she will mentally pick you apart.
Right.
She will pick you apart.
You got to understand that Eve is more prone to sin than the man is in the natural state. And because from Eve came the beginning of sin. And what did she do? She enticed Adam to follow her. Eve that actually made the covenant with Satan. And then she enticed her husband. So the Most High said, because you hearken to the voice of your wife, you're going to have to eat every day now. You're going to have to eat every day.
Sweat off your brow, yeah.
Right, so the scriptures say, Ecclesiasticus, Sirach, 25 verse 24, of the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. Verse 25, give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to go abroad. You can't trust her, man. Woo. You can't trust her around other men, because she's going to betray you. If she goes
That's
not...
deep right there.
But check this part out. If your woman is not listening to you, if she does not want to follow this truth, check out what the scripture said. Sirach 25 and 26. If she go not as thou wouldest have her, cut her off from thy flesh. That means you put her away. That means you divorce her. But you got to be strong enough to do that. You got to be strong enough to do that. And give her a bill of divorce and let her go. Mm-hmm. Now get your wife out of that. She's wicked. What are you still doing with your wife if she's wicked? She won't listen to you. She running off at the mouth. She bucking up. She rebelling against this truth. You're supposed to cut her off, man. You're supposed to cut her off. Now, you brothers need to really muse over that and meditate on that scripture, man. And I hope you receive this from the spirit that we're giving it, because we're not picking on anyone, man. Because I've seen women do some wicked things to these Aki, man.
Come on, I want to read something. Now, you see how the trial was symbolic to fire.
Right.
When you look at Hebrews 11 and 17, it says, by faith, that's how it starts off. Understand that if you don't have faith in the Most High's word and his way, this ain't gonna work for you. It said, by faith, Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac. And he that had received the promises offered up his only begotten son. So Abraham loved his son. When you read the scriptures, it tell you how long he waited to receive a son that he can pass on his inheritance to.
Right.
Now watch this. A lot of you brothers, guess what you got to do? You got to take your woman to the altar, man. You got to put her in God's hands. You got to get away from her. You got to just hand her over to the Most High. Because the Most High got to fix her, man. She ain't listening to your voice no more.
That's right.
You got to put her up on the altar.
That's right.
This is what Abraham had to do with his son. And when the Most High gave him clearance, he good. What happened? He received more blessings for having faith that the Most High wasn't leading him wrong. But a lot of brothers, they don't wanna take their wives to the altar and let God deal with them. Let God send the trials upon them. Try their hearts and souls to see what you're dealing with. Whether he destroyed them or make them better. But a lot of y'all are not ready for that. But y'all need to get your minds ready for that. Because it's exactly what you need to do. If you want peace in your heart, you want peace in your life, you want your fruits to you want to bring forth righteous fruits, that's exactly what you're going to have to do. I'm going to read another scripture in Sirach. It says, watch this, Sirach 34 and 23. When one buildeth and another pulleth down, what profit have they then but labor? So, if you got somebody, every time you're trying to build something, they pulling it down, that's not helping you. That's not profiting you. So a lot of you brothers, because when you first got in this truth, you was with these women, and you tried to be patient and give them the truth, and they ain't want it, and you choose to still be with them, you have been building this truth for so long and you can't see the results of it because the woman been pulling everything you've been building down.
Right.
So you got to put her on the altar, brother.
Right.
You got to put her on the altar. You got to give her to the Most High. Just right, like Most High, you deal with her.
If she receive it.
Yeah, you deal with her. Because I can't deal with her no more. I don't want to talk to her. I don't want to be around her. Because right now, she is not for me. She is my enemy. Because the spirit of Satan is in her. She don't see that yet. She thinks she just doing her own plan in her own mind. A lot of them don't even realize they got spirits in them that's driving them to fight against the righteous man of God.
And if you're not careful, that demon, she will put demons on you.
Come.
Your woman will put demons on you. Now, this is not for the righteous sisters that's out there. Because there is some righteous sisters out there that's humble and they will listen to their husband. They allow their husband to be the head. But, you know, this message is pretty much for the weak brothers out there that's allowing them, those women to control them, that's allowing them, their wives, to prevent them from coming to camp, and that's allowing them, their wives, to prevent them from studying this Bible and keeping these laws as they should be kept.
God.
And with that, I'm going to bring this to a close, brother.
I'll read this last scripture.
Bring out that
another,
last
another thing that these sisters will do to try to assert authority over their men. They said, well, I'm a prophetess, you know?
Yeah.
And I had this dream, and the Most High promised he going to use me greatly. So you got to listen to what I'm saying because God is with me in all this noise. If you go to Ecclesiasticus 34 and verse 1, the hope of a man void of understanding are vain and false. The dreams lift up fools. Whoso regardeth dreams is like him that casteth a shadow, catcheth a shadow, and followeth after the wind. The vision of dreams is the resemblance of one thing to another, even as the likeness of a face to a face, and of an unclean thing, what can be cleaned? And from that thing which is false, what truth can come? Divinations and smoothsayers and dreams are vain, and the heart finances as the woman's heart in travail. It's that if they be not sent from the Most High in thy visitation, set not thy heart upon them. So they're talking about all these dreams, but all their dreams seem to go against the scriptures.
Right.
He said, don't set your heart upon it. Don't listen to those dreams. Look, it says, for dreams have deceived many, and they have failed that put their trust in them. The law shall be found perfect without lies, and the wisdom is perfection to a faithful mouth. So rely on the scriptures. Don't listen to that woman and allow yourself to be under her authority.
Right. And with that, brothers, all of you young men out there, all of you older men that's listening to this video, and this spirit touch you in a certain way, send us an email at Lordship of Israel. Tune in to the radio show on Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Truth, the New Hate Speech. Like this video, share this video, email us, get in contact, and come on down and study at Timbuktu Bookstore. You're going to have to stop allowing your women to rule over you or your woman to rule over you. You're going to have to be a man. If you truly want to learn how to be a man according to this Bible, come on down, study, join us, so you can raise your children right. And if your wife is in the right spirit, then she's going to humble herself and get online. But if she's rebellious, you might have just came into the truth, like the brother said, and now your rib is seeing you changing, and she doesn't like it, God. And she's bucking up against the truth.
Uh-huh.
And truth is, brother, you may have to end up putting her away if she doesn't listen to you.
Let the Most High deal
if she keeps rebelling against you, you may have to let the Most High deal with her, and he will bless you with someone better.
God.
If she doesn't want to submit to this truth, he will bless you with someone better. That's all I got.
With that, we say shalom.
Shalom.